For over 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun. Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win. The Granite State Challenge! Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
Hi again, everybody, and welcome once again to another game of Granite State Challenge. We are still right in the middle of our opening round of 16 opening round games. As a matter of fact, we have already completed 10. The 10 high schools winning contest to advance to our upcoming second round. Two schools tonight, they're ready to go at each other. The winner also to come into our second round of play. Let us introduce you to the two schools playing in tonight's game. First of all, we have the team from Gorham Middle High School, enrolling some 179 students, located in New Hampshire's Coos County.
Hello, I'm Chris, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Dan, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Ryan, and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Tyler, and I'm a junior.
With us for the program is the coach for the team. He is Peter Gagnon. His alternates are Maggie Currier and Alyssa Carlisle, and they are the Huskies from Gorham Middle High School. All right, let's find out who's going to be playing against Gorham in tonight's game. This will be the team from Moultonborough Academy. It has an enrollment of about 250 students. Moultonborough Academy, located in New Hampshire's Carroll County.
Hi, I'm Caitlin, and I'm a senior.
Hey, I'm Kyle, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Jerrica, and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Courtney, and I'm a sophomore.
The team is coached by Vicki Johnson. Her alternates are Sarah Gavitas and Cameron McInnes, and they are the Panthers from Moultonborough Academy. Our last introduction is to introduce you to our judges, as we do at this point each and every week. And once again, Mary Riley Potter and Ann Belanger, thank you very much for your assistance. All right, round number one is a 10-point toss-up round. 60-second round, bonus round, they're just ahead. But right now, Gorham Middle School and Moultonborough, we're ready to go with 10-point toss-ups for you. Here we go. What does the C stand for in the equation E equals MC squared? Courtney of Moultonborough.
Acceleration.
Gorham. It stands for the speed of light. The lead singer and the guitarist for this iconic American rock band met at the Anchorage, a Sunapee, New Hampshire ice cream parlor. Name the band. Chris of Gorham.
Aerosmith.
Aerosmith is right for your 10 points. What U.S. president delivered fireside chats on the radio? Dan of Gorham Middle School.
FDR.
That's correct. Franklin Roosevelt for your 10 points. This sculptor, born in Exeter, New Hampshire, is perhaps best known for his statue of the seated Abraham Lincoln at the Lincoln Memorial. His name is Daniel Chester French. This country gets its name from the line of latitude that runs through it. Chris of Gorham.
Ecuador.
Ecuador is correct. This pirate in Robert Louis Stevenson's Treasure Island, Chris of Gorham.
Long John Silver.
Long John Silver, often depicted with his Captain Flint perched on his shoulder. All right, here we go with another 10-pointer. This renowned 19th century American landscape painter spent the last 25 years of his life in Prout's Neck, Maine. Some of his works include Snap the Whip, The Gulf Stream, and Breezing Up. American landscape painter.
Dan? Kincaid.
Moultonborough. His name was Winslow Homer. All right, you got paper and pencil in front of you. Let's use it for the first time tonight with a little bit of math. If Jane traveled 495 miles in 11 hours, what was her average speed? Simple as that. If Jane traveled 495 miles and she did it in 11 hours, we want to know her average speed. Kyle of Moultonborough.
11.5 miles per hour.
Gorham. It is 45 miles per hour. All right, here's your next toss-up. Name the Geoffrey Chaucer work that features a collection of stories. Tyler of Gorham.
The Canterbury Tales.
The Canterbury Tales is right for 10 points. Star Island is the largest of this group of islands found off the New Hampshire coast. Dan of Gorham.
The Isles of Shoals.
The Isles of Shoals is also correct. Now what we want you to do is name the river that flows through the Grand Canyon. Caitlin of Moultonborough.
Columbia.
Gorham. Dan.
The Colorado.
It is the Colorado River. Name the tissue that makes up a human skeleton in its earliest stages of development. Courtney of Moultonborough.
Skeletal tissue.
I can repeat for Gorham. Name the tissue that makes up a human skeleton in its earliest stages of development and the entire skeleton of any jawless fish. Dan.
Cartilage.
Cartilage is right. What river follows the Kangamangas Highway? Jericho of Moultonborough.
Connecticut.
Gorham. It is the Swift River. This American composer and conductor was the conductor of the Boston Pops Orchestra from 1980 to 1993, and he composed the film scores for Jaws. Chris of Gorham.
John Williams.
John Williams, also Jurassic Park and the Star Wars saga. Ashland, New Hampshire native Dr. George H. Whipple won a Nobel Prize in 1936 in what field? In the field of medicine. Paper and pencil in front of you once again, teams. In square inches, what is the total surface area of a 3-inch cube? In square inches, what is the total surface area of a 3-inch cube? Jerrica?
18 square inches.
Say again.
18.
Gorham? Ryan?
36 square inches.
Well, add another 18 to that and you've got your 54 square inches. The word scuba is actually an acronym. What does it stand for? Chris of Gorham.
Self-contained underwater breathing apparatus.
You got it, correctly done for 10 points. How many U.S. states border the Pacific Ocean? Ryan of Gorham.
3.
Moultonborough. Kyle.
5.
5 is right. You have Alaska and Hawaii in there as you also think of the west coast of Washington, Oregon, and California. All right, 10 points for Moultonborough. What name is given to any chemical substance that produces hydrogen ions when dissolved in water and turns litmus? Caitlin of Moultonborough.
Acid.
Acid is correct for your 10 points. How many compartments are there in a cow's stomach? Jerrica of Moultonborough.
6.
Good try, Gorham. Dan.
10.
It is 4. This 20th century American painter is best known for his works depicting rural life in the Midwest. His best known painting, American Gothic, features a pitchfork wielding farmer and his wife. Tyler of Gorham.
Grant Wood.
You got it. Grant Wood is well done for your 10 points. And there's the sound ending our round. So it is Gorham getting the early lead in our game after a good opening round by a score of 110 to 20. But we've got our bonus round just around the corner. A lot of points up for grabs. Before we get there, though, Lori Warner joins us again this week talking with the members of the two teams participating. Right now, she's talking with a team from Gorham Middle High School.
Well, thank you, Jim. We're here with the students from Gorham High School. And first, we'll start with our captain, Chris Turgeon. You are the senior here.
Yes, I am.
And out of all of the activities, because he had listed, like, I don't know, 30, 40 activities that you do.
Oh.
Which one's your favorite?
I would have to say Quiz Bowl, because I'm here right now, and it got me on TV.
I like him. I do. I like him a lot. All right. What's your second favorite?
I'd say Scouts, because I'm an Eagle, so that really... This is a big enjoyment for me.
Mm-hmm. And that's a lot of work.
It is.
Many, many hours of chores and tasks and accomplishments and all sorts of good stuff. So congratulations on that, by the way.
Thank you.
And we have Dan.
Yeah.
Dan, you're a junior.
I am.
And so far you backpacked to New Mexico for 2 weeks.
Yeah, we backpacked in right around Cimarron, and it was an amazing experience.
Yeah. How did that end up happening?
It was a trip through the state Boy Scouts, and I got picked to go on it, so I went.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Burrows.
Part of it.
Okay.
Most of it was just on your back, though.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It sounds like too much work.
Oh, it's fun.
It does sound like fun. And speaking of accomplishing things, Ryan, you and your dad, you have a very unique accomplishment. And what was that you did this past summer?
This summer, me and my dad climbed all of the 5,000-footer mountains in New Hampshire.
Wow. Now, what made you decide to do that?
It was just something me and my dad wanted to do. We both enjoy hiking, and we could do it together, and we decided this would be a good year to do it because we were hiking about the same speed this year.
Oh, that's good. And next year you'll pass him, right?
Probably.
Haha, Dad. And Tyler. Tyler Burnett, you are the filmmaker amongst the crowd, the artsy kind of guy. So how did you get into that?
Mostly growing up watching a lot of like Woody Allen and films like that made by Stanley Kubrick, influential people like that.
Well, I notice that you have all sorts of older films as your influence.
Yeah.
What would be your favorite?
It's between probably...
There's just too many to pick, aren't there?
Yes, I
all
guess.
Right. See, if I had to pick one, I'd pick Dodgeball, but that's just like so bad. Anyway, it's time for us to get back to the game now, so best of luck, and we are over to you, Jim.
Thank you very much, Lori. As you look at the team from Gorham as we enter the second round, Gorham holding on to the lead over Moultonborough, but we come to our bonus round. We'll still ask the 10-point toss-up questions, but the team that identifies the toss-up correctly then has a chance at additional bonus points. So it's a big round. Good luck, Gorham Middle High School and Moultonborough Academy, for 10 points. Name the author of Frankenstein. Chris of Gorham Middle.
Mary Shelley.
Mary Shelley is right for the 10 points. So let's go over to Gorham. And Chris, you're the team captain. You'll be speaking for them. But right now, talk to your teammates and choose between Yes, Sir, He's the Man, or Great Inventors. Yes, Sir, He's the Man, or Great Inventors.
Great Inventors.
Let's go with Great Inventors. And again, Chris, I take your answer for the team after you talk to them. Name the person credited with inventing the following devices. The telephone.
Alexander Graham Bell.
Correct. The cotton gin.
Eli Whitney.
Correct. Archimedes screw.
Archimedes.
Couldn't fool you, huh? 15 out of 15 on the bonus. Well done. Let's go with a 10-point toss-up. In what Central American country are the Pacific and the Atlantic Oceans only 48 miles apart? Dan of Gorham.
Panama.
Panama is right for another 10 points for Gorham. So back to them we go for Yes, Sir, He's the Man, and Top of the Charts. Yes, Sir, He's the Man, or Top of the Charts.
Doesn't matter.
Top of the Charts.
Let's go with Top of the Charts. We want you to identify the artist who performed these songs listed among the 500 greatest songs of all time by Rolling Stone magazine. Like a Rolling Stone.
My hero, Bob Dylan.
Bob Dylan.
Correct. I Can't Get No Satisfaction.
The Rolling Stones.
The Rolling Stones.
Correct. Imagine.
John Lennon.
You notice the musician helped out a little bit on that one. 15 out of 15 on the toss-up. This comic science fiction work by Douglas Adams featuring Marvin, Jerrica of Moultonborough.
Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
That's correct. The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Well done. So let's go over to Moultonborough. Caitlin, you're the team captain. You can talk to everybody. Choose from Yes, Sir, He's the Man, or A Matter of Character. Yes, Sir, He's the Man, A Matter of Character.
Matter of Character.
Matter of Character. Let's go. A Matter of Character. Identify the novel associated with the following characters. Hester Prynne, Arthur Dimmesdale, and Pearl. It was The Scarlet Letter. Ralph, Jack, and Piggy. Was Lord of the Flies. And Atticus Finch, Scout, and Boo Radley.
To Kill a Mockingbird.
You got it. 5 out of 15 on the bonus. All right, let's go with another 10-pointer. What is the oldest institution of higher education in the United States? Caitlin of Moultonborough.
Harvard.
Harvard is right for another 10 points. So back over to Moultonborough we go. We still have a Yes, Sir, He's the Man, and 1984.
Caitlin.
Yes, Sir, He's the Man, 1984.
He's the man.
Caitlin?
He's the man.
He's the man. It will be for 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following novels with the word man or men in the title. Novel for which Robert Penn Warren won the 1947 Pulitzer Prize. It was All the King's Men. And remember, these have man or men in the title. John Steinbeck novel that tells the story of migrant workers George Milton and Lenny Small.
Of Mice and Men.
Correct. A novel in which Santiago dreams about lions on the beach. And that is The Old Man and the Sea. And another 5 points on the scoreboard for your bonus. Let's try another one. Into which bay does the Ganges River flow? Jerrica of Moultonborough.
Bay of Bengal.
The Bay of Bengal is correct for another 10 points. So Moultonborough getting the hang of things as we go back to them for Yes Sir, 1984 and Down Under. Yes Sir, 1984, Down Under.
Down Under.
Let's go with Down Under. Identify each of the following concerning Australia. Leaves on which the koala feeds.
Eucalyptus. Eucalyptus.
Correct. Fierce animal that eats small mammals and reptiles and lives on the Australian island of Tasmania.
Tasmanian devil.
Correct. Kingfisher with a loud laugh that sits in the old gum tree in a popular children's song.
A mockingbird?
It is the kookaburra, but they get 10 out of 15 on their bonus and the buzzer sounds ending the round. Things tightened up a little bit, but Gorham got that lead in the first round, holding on to it halfway through. 60-second round, though, coming up, and 110 points up for grabs for each team. Before we get there, here's Lori once again, this time talking with the team members from Moultonborough Academy.
Thank you, Jim. We're here with Moultonborough Academy, and we have our captain, Caitlin O'Hara. Now, Caitlin, you're a senior.
Yes, I am.
And when you graduate, you're going to listen to the punk music in the operating room because you're going to become a doctor.
That's my hope. A couple years ago, I really started becoming interested in medicine, and the last few years, I've had the time to actually go into operating rooms, witness that. I've had surgery myself, and I spent a week last summer at the National Youth Leadership Forum on Medicine in Boston, and being completely immersed in that field just kind of gave me the whole idea to really get into it more.
No, it is a wonderful thing, it is, and you can do so much good, so we wish you the best of luck with that. And Courtney Delaney, you're a sophomore, now you're an identical twin.
Yep.
And your sister also has pink glasses?
Nah, only me.
Neither mine.
All right, but you went to John Hopkins Center for Talented Youth. Now, how did that come about?
Well, I was accepted into it. I didn't actually go, but my brother also went, and it was just sort of a family thing, taking tests and seeing what we can do with it.
Doing well with it.
Yep.
All right, well, cool. That's good. It's good to be accepted, and sometimes it's even more fun to go. Kyle Fest, now you just moved to New Hampshire.
Yes, I did.
And how are you liking it so far?
It's nice. The climate's really good. The weather's a lot better than down in Florida.
Yeah.
It's pretty brutal down there. It's like 100 degrees every day. Not good.
Okay, well, we had that kind of a summer. This was a really hot summer for us. So.
Hot? No.
Oh, yeah, it was. But you also love to draw in Japanese cartoons. How did that come about?
I do. It's been something I've enjoyed since I was about, like, I don't know, 7 years old, and ever since I was playing Pokemon on my Game Boy, so it was pretty fun. Yeah.
So you're artistic, obviously.
Oh, yeah.
All right, well, cool. That is an interesting hobby. And Jerrica, you are a sophomore also?
Yes,
and you really would like to talk about Latin.
Latin, yeah. We have Latin at Moultonborough Academy, and it's a really cool language. Like, it's cool to see how, like, it manifests itself in, like, other languages, like French and, like, Spanish and, of course, English. Yeah, it's really cool.
Yeah. And then if you ever wanted to be a doctor, too, you'd have to.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
There we go. All right. We've got Moultonborough Academy all wrapped up for the future. And speaking of wrapping up, it is time to get back to the game and to you, Jim.
Once again, Lori, thank you very much. That's the team from Moultonborough Academy. And as we head into round number three, they're ready for a big round to get back into this thing. 60-second round, we'll ask 10 questions to each team. 10 points for every correct answer, and if you get them all right in under a minute, we bonus you 10 points for a total of 110. As a matter of fact, that happened for the first time this season last week. Let's find out if it can happen again today. Moultonborough, you choose first, so choose from these categories. First and last, good fences make good neighbors, in character. First and last, good fences make good neighbors, in character.
Okay.
First and last.
First and last. And Caitlin, you talk to everybody, but I do take your answer for the team. What we want you to do is identify these people whose first and last names begin with the same letter. Start the clock. poet who wrote Leaves of Grass?
Walt Whitman.
Correct. Wife and mother of the 41st and 43rd presidents?
Pass.
Wife and mother of the 2nd and 6th presidents?
Abigail Adams.
Correct. President when the stock market crashed in 1929?
Herbert Hoover.
Correct. Famous blonde actress in the 1950s and early 60s. She starred in Gentlemen Prefer Blonde.
Marilyn Monroe.
Correct. Popeye's girlfriend.
Olive oil.
Correct. Lead singer for Black Sabbath and star of a reality show featuring
his Ozzy Osbourne.
Correct. Composer of An American in Paris and Rhapsody in Blue. Oh.
Pass.
Irish author of the novels Ulysses and Finnegan's Wake.
Pass.
Daughter of Bill and Hillary Clinton.
Chelsea Clinton.
Correct. Judges?
Seven.
Did you say?
Yes.
Seven. Very well done. 7 out of 10 on there. 60-second round. So 70 points onto the scoreboard for Moultonborough. We go over to Gorham Middle High School and we offer you Good Fences Make Good Neighbors or In Character. Good Fences Make Good Neighbors or In Character.
Good Fences Make Good Neighbors.
All right, Good Fences Make Good Neighbors. Chris, you talk to everybody. I take your answer for the team. Identify the following associated barriers or borders. Start the clock. Wall that separated East and West Germany during the Cold War.
Berlin Wall.
Correct. Jewish religious site located in the old city of Jerusalem.
Wailing Wall.
Correct. These barriers found all over New Hampshire were originally built by farmers to mark boundaries.
Stone walls.
Correct. Series of walls in northern China built to repel invading nomads from the north.
Great Wall of China.
Correct. Title of the Robert Frost poem in which the line "Good fences make good neighbors" appears.
Pass.
This American military base is separated from Cuba by an 8-mile barrier of cactus called the Cactus Curtain.
Guantanamo Bay.
Correct. In 2002, the U.S. Supreme Court settled a long-standing dispute between Maine and New Hampshire over the ownership of CB Island located in this river.
Pass.
The DMZ, the most heavily defended border in the world, lies between what two countries?
South and North Korea.
Correct. The only U.S. state with no border. And there's the sound ending the round. Judges?
Hawaii.
They get 6 out of 10 on their 60-second round. So 60 points onto the scoreboard for Gorham. And as we are 3/4 of the way through the game, Gorham maintaining that lead that they got back in round number one. But we still have a good one going. Plenty of time left to go with 10-point toss-ups the rest of the way. No more talking to each other, teams. Good luck. Here we go, Gorham and Moultonborough. Who was the only U.S. vice president and president not elected to either office? Chris
Gerald
of Gorham.
Ford.
Say again, Gerald Ford.
Ford
is right. What is the maximum number of electrons that can be found in the third energy level of an atom? Caitlin.
8.
Gorham. Ryan.
6.
It is 18. What Shakespearean play features the character Puck? Jerrica of Moultonborough? Gorham? It is A Midsummer Night's Dream. Just under 2 minutes to go in our game. Used in s'mores and pie crust, these were once called honey biscuits, Caitlin of Moultonborough.
Graham crackers.
Graham crackers, well done. Name the World War II general who said, "Old soldiers never die, they just fade away." Dan of Gorham.
Patton.
Moultonborough. Caitlin.
MacArthur.
Douglas MacArthur is correct. With what 4 words did Johnny Cash begin every performance? Caitlin of Moultonborough.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash. We're going to give that to you as correct. Name 2 of the 3 world leaders who met at the Yalta Conference in 1945. Tyler of Gorham.
Winston Churchill, Joseph, and Joseph Stalin.
That is correct. Franklin Roosevelt being the 3rd. 1 minute to go in our game. Which German scientist discovered X-rays in 1895 and won the first Nobel Prize in Physics in 1901? It was William Röntgen. How many transatlantic trips did the Titanic make before sinking? Chris of Gorham.
None.
None is correct. Director Francis Ford Coppola moved the action from the Congo to Vietnam in Apocalypse Now, his film adaptation of what Joseph Conrad novel, Tyler of Gorham?
Heart of Darkness.
Heart of Darkness is correct. Who was the Aztec ruler during the Spanish conquest of the Aztec Empire? Caitlin of Moultonborough.
Montezuma.
Montezuma is right. Now we want you to identify the tiny pores through which plants primarily give off water. Ryan of Gorham.
Stomata.
Stomata is correct. For 10 points, what is the end of the game and what is the score? It will be Gorham 270 and Moultonborough Academy 180. Well played, but that big opening round did it for Gorham tonight. So congratulations to Gorham High School and to Moultonborough. Very well played. We hope it was fun for the both teams. Actually, we hope it was fun for you at home as well, and that you'll join us again here, same time, same place, come next week. We have an interesting battle next week, an interesting opening round game. It'll be the teams from Nashua North High School and Nashua South High School going against each other. Should be fun. Hope you enjoyed it. See you next week. Good night, everybody.